Welcome. One of Satan's great lies is that you can be like God. Well, what we've been considering over the last week is God's nature and his character and what his works have been and comparing them to ourselves. We want to continue that today. And the first characteristic of God that I'd like to consider is that God is eternal. He is immortal. And by this we mean that God never had a beginning and God will never have an end. Kind of maybe something like God is outside of time. You say, no, wait a minute. I was born, so I wasn't there always, but I was born, I had started at a point in time, and since I'm a Christian, since I believe in Jesus, I know that when I die, it's not the end. Jesus is going to give me a resurrected body and bring me to heaven, where I'm going to be with him and the Father forever. So yeah, in some respects, I'm like God. I have a beginning. God didn't have a beginning, but I'm going to be around forever with God. The next characteristic I'd like us to consider is God is everywhere. You know, in science, they define a gas as something that expands to fill its container. Well, God being everywhere is, you know, maybe a little bit like that. God expands to fill his creation. Whatever God has created, God is there. So wait a minute. I'm certainly not much like that. I'm stuck in time. I can only be in one place at one time. So I'm really nothing like God for that. The next characteristic I'd like you to consider is God is holy. God is all good. He's perfect. He never makes a mistake. Say, well, you know, I've done some good things. You know, I gave some money to that great charity, and I volunteered at the soup line, and I made sandwiches. I made meals for kids who were starving. I've done some pretty good things in my life. But perfect? I can't claim to be perfect. I mean, you know, I still am not patient all the time. You know, and I've been known to gossip a little bit and lust when I shouldn't lust. And, you know, I'm certainly not patient. But I'm a little bit like God because I'm able to do some good things. But, no, I'm not, certainly not perfect. And the last characteristic I'd like you to consider, I don't even know what the name is, but let me ask you this question. If two people were to pray at the same time in different places, would God hear both of them? So, oh, sure, God would hear both of them. What if it was three people? Would God hear them? Would he listen to them? Yeah, I think it was three people. Well, what if the number was 1,000? What if the number was 10,000? What if the number was 1,000,000? Would God still listen to every one of them individually and hear and be concerned about what they're praying about? Yeah, even if it was 1,000,000,000. And you say, well, you know, I'm nothing like that. Oh, man, I have a hard time just having one conversation with one other person. Yet God can listen to 1,000,000,000 people pray at the same time. Well, your assignment for this week is to continue to think about the nature of God. Think about who God is and what God has done and compare yourself to him. And what I think you'll come to the same conclusion that I did. That God is God and I am not. Well, thank you very much for watching. Have a great rest of your day. Aloha. See you there.